It's been quite a while since an American car company offered a diesel-powered sedan here in America. So is a Chevy Cruze Diesel worth the wait? In a word, yes. GM's finally brought forth a worthy contender to the Volkswagen Jetta TDI, as well as an interesting contrast to the thrifty Cruze Eco. While the gas-powered turbo 1.4-liter Cruze Eco provides 138 horsepower and 148 foot-pounds of torque, a Garrett turbo pumps the Cruze Diesel's 2-liter up to 151 horsepower and 264 foot-pounds of torque. Fuel economy jumps from 26 city 39 highway in the Eco automatic to 27 city 46 highway in the diesel. Does it sound different? Of course. Some folks love the sound, some folks don't, and some folks could care less. We rolled up over 700 miles in our week-long test, scoring an average of 39.9 miles per gallon combined and 50.5 miles per gallon on the interstate highway with a target cruising speed of 68 miles per hour. Conservative drivers will see their numbers climb even higher over time. That's the beauty of diesel. More power and better fuel economy. Now off the line, it's a little sluggish. The turbo has to spool up. Once you're on the roll, you hit that power band pretty early, you're good. You're right into it. If you need to pass, say, going from 45 to 60, it's like that. I'm about to get on the interstate, and this will give you a feel for what a merge is like in the Cruze Diesel. Right now, we're at 47 miles per gallon, 12 and a half miles into this segment, and 30 miles an hour. Let's punch it. That took us up to 65 pretty well. No problem making the merge. Did drop down our MPGs, of course. We're at 45.5 at this point. And going over a rather noisy concrete bridge. So here's a 58 to 5. Purists will lament that the Cruze Diesel is only available with a conventional 6-speed automatic transmission, albeit with a slapstick. They'll miss the enjoyment of shifting a proper manual or the crispness of a dual-clutch automatic. The Cruze Diesel's higher price isn't just due to its diesel technology. That price also brings a higher level of trim with a leather interior with 3-level heated front bucket seats. The trim level is similar to a top-of-the-line gasoline-powered Cruze. Chevy's MyLink infotainment system is standard with all the Bluetooth and digital audio goodies, including Pandora and Stitcher integration. The USB and auxiliary audio input jacks are inside the center console. There's a 12-volt outlet between the shifter and driver's seat and another one at the back of the console. The back seat provides 37.9 inches of headroom and 35.4 inches of legroom. The Cruze Diesel does not come with a spare tire. The diesel emission fluid tank sits in its place and contains 4.5 gallons, enough for 10,000 miles. A tire inflation kit is provided. There's 13.3 cubic feet of cargo area in the trunk. That's 1.7 cubic feet less than the gas-powered Cruze. A 60-40 split fold-down seat provides extra storage. While some folks will be quick to point out the trickery of the Cruze Diesel's active grille shutters and rear spoiler, the real aerodynamic magic can be found under the car in its expansive belly pans. This allows the Cruze Diesel's front air dam to not droop quite as low as its Impala and Bolt stablemates, making it easier to get in and out of steep driveways. The Cruze Diesel is ideal for the open road, with a 15.6-gallon fuel tank that allows for an enormous driving range. Think about this. 46 times 15.6. if anyone complains they can't find a service station with diesel fuel with that much range, they're driving on another planet.
Although the car is assembled in Lordstown, Ohio, the diesel engine is built in Germany by VM Motori, an Italian company co-owned by GM and Fiat. Variations of this 2-liter find their way into some interesting places. Could we see it show up in a larger GM sedan or thrifty crossover one day? Only time will tell.